Alonzo Clemens from Boulder in Colorado doesn't experience stage fright either. He doesn't even know what it is. As long as you let him do what he can do best, he's the happiest man on earth. Within only a few minutes, he can mold perfect animal sculptures out of any piece of clay, tar, or wax. Incidentally, we brought Alonzo to a horse farm in his neighborhood, only to let us, and you, see how accurate his clay animals are. Alonzo himself doesn't actually need a model. In this respect, he is a genius. Alonzo shapes his figures without even glancing at the horses. But when it comes to shaping a sentence, Alonzo faces huge problems.
What happened to Alonzo is when he was a young boy, maybe 2 or 3 years old, he had a bad accident in which he fell on his head. That accident caused severe injury to his brain.
Alonzo's brain never really recovered from this accident. He can neither read nor write, nor can he calculate, and he will never drive a car. Only his friends can understand him when he speaks, and Alonzo doesn't speak much. But he has taken part in the Special Olympics as a weightlifter. After years of being institutionalized, Alonzo now has a part-time job and a flat of his own. And he shapes animal figures, thousands of them. Each of them is absolutely perfect. Alonzo knows most of these animals only from books. One of the most intriguing talents of some savants is their ability to immediately transform every photograph into a 3D figure. Experts now believe that we all have similar talents, but that they have become overlaid by more complex abilities, such as language.
What kind of horse is it?
A wild horse, man.
It's a wild horse? A Mustang?
Yeah.
Okay. For the last year, he's been very interested in doing sculptures that have both an animal and a person. What is fascinating to me about this is that his savant chip or wiring in his brain that works so wonderfully when it comes to his animal sculptures is simply not there for the human form.
So far, there is no single theory that explains the amazing talents of all savants, because not everybody with injuries to the left hemisphere develops similar magical skills as Alonzo's. He is one of only 100 prodigious savants worldwide. He is not able to sculpt animals, he is compelled by his brain.
With Alonzo Clemens, when he was in a residential facility, they took his clay away for a period of time and said, now look, you got to learn how to comb your hair and tie your shoes. And when you do that, then we'll give you your clay back.
In the dorm where he lived, there were windows that had panes of glass. And sometimes the pane would get broken. He was so observant, he knew that pretty soon the maintenance man would be coming along, removing the broken glass, putting in a new pane, and all around the edges of that would be putting glazing or putty. As soon as the maintenance man was gone, there was Alonzo scraping off that putty so he could use it to sculpt with.